section 11.4, we're going to talk about shifted conics. Now, a conic section are the things we've been dealing with in the last few sections, parabolas, ellipses, and hyperbolas. And now we're going to look at shifting them away from that vertex being at the origin. And we're just talking about simple shifts where we take them, you know, so many units to the left or right and so many units up or down. We're not stretching and shrinking them because that really just turns them into a different one, which we already know how to find. So let's talk about first a shifted ellipse. So if we recall that an ellipse has the general equation x squared over a squared plus y squared over b squared equals 1. So remember that this one had a plus between it versus a negative on one of them, which was a hyperbola. If we shift it by h units to the right, that means we are supposed to put a minus h in next to the x, just like what we did shifts translations back in the previous chapters. Now if I want to go k units up, remember we usually added k to the outside of everything. If I put that right inside next to the y, it's the same kind of thing that happens with the x. It's actually a minus k over b squared. So that is shifting up k and right h units. So what we're going to do is we analyze these to find the vertices and the foci of the shifted ellipse. We're just going to look at the non-shifted ellipse, identify what the shift is, go back to the original and say what are the vertices and foci of this graph, and then just shift those vertices and foci appropriately. So it's not like we have new formulas, we're just going to shift them at the end. Let's look at an example. In example one, we've got in a nice format where we can see the shifts. So we know that the original, if we want to think about it, the pre-shifted or non-shifted is x squared over 9 plus y squared over 4 equals 1. And then we're shifting right 2 and up 1 unit. So let's look at the original. Now the denominator of the x squared term is the larger, so we know that this is going to be elongated in that horizontal direction. We know that it's going to have vertices then on that x-axis, and the vertices are going to be plus and minus a, which is the square root of this, so plus minus 3, 0. And we know our foci are going to be on that axis as well, and recall that they were the larger minus the smaller with 0. So we're going to have plus or minus the square root of 5, 0. And remember that we did have vertices on the minor axis of 0 plus or minus 2. Now let's shift those things right 2 and up 1. So the vertices on the major axis, it's still going to be elongated in that same way. They're going to go right 2, so they're going to go to, in fact, I'm going to do this on another page. So before we had plus or minus 3, 0. We have to actually deal with those separately now. So 3, 0 is going to go to the right, let's just write this down so I don't forget, right 2 and up 1. So right 2, so it's going to go to 5 and up 1. And negative 3, 0 is going to go right 2, so that brings it to negative 1, 1. And then those vertices on the minor axis, 0, 2, is going to now be at 2, 3. And 0, negative 2 is going to be at 2, up 1, negative 1. And then the foci, one was positive square root of 5, 0. Now that's going to be 2 plus square root of 5 and 1. And negative square root of 5, 0 is going to be 2 minus square root of 5 and 1. Because it's just negative square root of 5 plus 2, so I'll just write it that way. So in particular, these guys are the ones that are gonna help me graph it, so I can put my points on those points. So I've plotted those points, 5, 1, negative 1, 1. 2, 3, and 2, negative 1. And there's roughly my ellipse. My scale's a little off, but that's roughly my ellipse. And you can see that we've shifted over 2 and up 1 for that center. Okay, now for the parabola. If we'll, We're going to have the same types of shifts and the same type of work to find the vertex and the new focus if it's in that nice form. However, at this point, let's go back and practice finding the shifted equation by completing the square. So recall that we did this back in section 3.1 when we wanted to find the vertex of a parabola. And this is what we're going to need if we find an equation in this form, x squared plus 6x plus 12y plus 9 equals 0. That's an equation, a general equation for a shifted conic. We're going to talk about a general equation more in a few minutes, but first we're going to, if it only has one square in it, an x square, then this could be an equation for a parabola. So what we're going to do is we're going to put all the x terms on one side and everything else on the other. And we're going to complete the square over here. So we'd put all the x's on one, all the y's on the other. So let's complete the square. So x squared plus 6x. So if 6 was here, that means it's 2 times 3. So 3 squared is what we need. So if we're going to add that over to the left-hand side, we better add that to the right-hand side too. So that's 9 over there. In fact, let me just write it as 3 squared so that we're clear that what we're doing is just adding to both sides. So we completed the square. This is now x plus 3 squared. Go back and review that if you've forgotten how to do that. And then the plus 9 and minus 9 nicely cancel. So what we have here is a shifted graph because the original would have been x squared equals negative 12y. And that's a parabola that, if we had it 4py, that has p being negative 3. And now we've just shifted it to the left 3 units. So let's talk about what that original would have had. Okay, so we're looking at the original. P is negative 3. So these are all vertex at the origin in the original. Our focus here, because it's an x squared, is going to be at 0p, so that's 0, negative 3. And our directrix is going to be a horizontal line at y equals negative p, so that's negative, negative 3, so positive 3. Now we need to be really careful here. Our vertex shifts by this shift, but our focus and directrix have to be in respect to the vertex. So here our focus was 3 units below the vertex, and our directrix was 3 units above the vertex. And this was a parabola that opens down. So it's still a parabola that opens down. Now its vertex is going to shift to the left 3 units. So it's going to go to negative 3, 0. So it's over there, negative 3, 0. But my focus is 3 units above it. So my focus is 3 units below the vertex. So the focus is now at negative 3, negative 3. And my directrix, now it's still a horizontal line, and it has to be 3 units above the vertex. Well, the vertex didn't change in going up or down, so this actually doesn't change. Y is still 3, because that's 3 units above where this is on the x-axis. Okay, so that gives us our vertex, focus, and directrix. And you see that it really did just shift the vertex and shift the focus, but the directrix you got to think about. All right, now for the general equation of a shifted conic. Here's the general equation, and A and B cannot both be 0. Cannot both be 0. And sometimes what this will result in is a degenerate conic, which means that it actually doesn't come out to be one of the perfect conics sections that we have. But if it's non-degenerate, then we have one of three cases. It's a parabola if either A or B equals 0, so we only have one squared term. It's an ellipse if A and B have the same sign. And in fact, it's a circle if they're equal. If A is equal to B, then we actually have a circle. And three, it's a hyperbola if A and B have opposite signs. And we're still going to have to complete the square to find exactly what we have. So here we have a generic case, and this is going to be a hyperbola because we have x and y, x squared and y squared, and we have opposite signs. So in order to complete the square, we're going to put all of the x terms together, x squared minus 96x, and then we're going to put all the y terms together where there's only one, and then we're going to put the constant on the other side. So now let's complete the square. Well, 16 actually factors out of that, and we're left with x squared minus 6x minus 9y squared equals negative 288. So to complete that square, because we have minus 6x, we must have 6 divided by 2 is 3, so we've got to do 3 squared here. And then we are adding 16 times 3 squared to this side, so we'll add 16 times 3 squared to this side. So we have 16 times x minus 3 squared minus 9 squared. And over here we end up with 144. Positive 144. So we have to divide everything by 144, and that turns out to give you x cubed x minus 3 squared over 9 minus y squared over 16 equals 1. Now, in a degenerate case, we're going to get something equal to 0 over here, so it's not possible to get a 1, and we know that we have to have a 1 for the case of a hyperbola or an ellipse. So there we go. And we know our original is x squared over 9 minus y squared over 16 equals 1, and we have a shift to the right 3 units. So let's take a look at the original. Since we have the positive on the x, we have vertices at plus and minus 3, 0. We have asymptotes at y equals plus or minus b, 4 over 3x. And we have foci, not that we always graph these, but in fact, yeah, at plus or minus c, so that's plus or minus the square root of 9 plus 16, 0. And that comes out to be 25, so plus or minus 5, 0, nicely enough. So what about our new one? So our center is going to shift to 3, 0. Our vertices, well, the 3, 0 is going to shift, so vertices. 3, positive 3 zeros are going to switch to 6, 0. Negative 3, 0 is going to shift to 0, 0. The foci, 5, 0 is going to shift to 8, 0. Negative 5, 0 is going to be negative 2, 0. And the asymptotes are going to shift in the same way. We're going to go right to, so it's y equals plus or minus 4 thirds times x plus 3. Sorry, x minus 3. So that's going to be a minus 3 times x minus 3. Okay, so those will be our center, foci, vertices, and asymptote of the shifted hyperbola. And we just got to make sure that we are careful with these guys. So again, you're probably going to have to complete the square in order to do this. So look back through that section if you've forgotten and be picking it out from the general equation which of the cases we're in. And that finishes up this section.